This is the Doom Tomb Podcast, the podcast for all things stoner, doom, and sludge. And we've got a band for a top five today. They were on the podcast last year, and we're going to welcome them back. Welcome back, Ivan and Mike. And if you listen closely, some of the music that you'll hear was off of something they released in October of 2020 called the Forest Session EP. It was done in Steventown, New York, and it was recorded live. So, you know, if you're digging that, head over to Bandcamp, buy a copy, and I think they still have some patches left. Grab a patch while you're at it. And now, let's get into their top five. Ivan and Mike, or is it Yvonne? How do you pronounce
Yvonne.
It? Yvonne.
Yeah.
I apologize.
No, it's...
What is your top five?
First of all, it's top five of everything. It's not themed in a certain way, but it's just in general.
It's the top five things in your life.
Exactly.
Okay, yeah. So first, and I like that it's number one, family first.
Yep.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. So... Do you still have people a family over in Russia?
Yeah. I have a half brother. Mike has his brothers, his mother and father. I have a niece there. I have cousins. There's a lot of family there, and a lot of friends, and a lot of musicians that we played out throughout the years that we, you know, booked the shows with and did a lot of different projects. So we still have a lot of connections there.
So do you think that you are going to play over there sometime? You know, when everything, all the travel bans get lifted and all that crap?
For this, there has to be a very big changes in, you know, in Russia in general.
Okay.
Because originally just a small vignette, we actually left Russia because of one of the songs that we've recorded.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. No, I guess what the Russian government just says no to that. They don't buy it.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
They didn't share our musical talent.
Okay. Is that material out somewhere?
Yeah. There is an online. We do have links for that.
Okay, interesting. I might want to get one of those. Even if we don't put it out, I want to see what that was all about.
Sure.
Okay, so what is the second most important part of your life?
Electrical guitars.
Okay. Now,
specific.
What is his favorite? And on top of that, I saw that there was somebody in the band was using Earthquaker pedal. And we talked about that with a previous band, Dear Lord. And yeah. I'm curious, is there any more pedals or anything that you're looking forward to getting?
Во-первых, какая у тебя любимая гитара, а во-вторых, какие тебе вещи еще хотелось бы достать, получить?
Любимая гитара Fender Stratocaster.
The favorite guitar would be Fender Stratocaster.
Она как настоящий мотоцикл Хог Харли Дэвидсон, ее можно разобрать на столе и собрать.
Because as a you know a real chopper or a real motorcycle, you can take it apart on the table with just a single screwdriver, and then you can put it back together with all the modifications that you want to do.
And there's so many people that were monster fans of it, you know, in the beginning stages of what we would call heavy rock or acid rock or whatever. So, are there any other pedals that he's going to be getting soon? Anything that he's got his eye on?
Сейчас вот на первом месте у меня по юзабилити это, конечно, Earthquaker девайс. Они очень хорошие. У них все примочки очень хорошие.
On the first in the list would be the Earthquaker devices because their pedals are amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Just in general.
Я использую Hoof и Acapulco Gold и Raptor.
He's Mike is using Eruptor, the Acapulco Gold, and the Huff as the prime suspects of this.
You know, and while we're talking about that, what's his rig like? What do you got as your stack?
So our main amplifiers for the guitar, we're using either the solid state Rendell, or we have
RX120RH.
Yeah, RX120RH, and we are using Marshall. Is it Plexi 15? Oh, Origin 15.
Yeah.
So it's a full valve, no effect sidechain. Yeah, just single channel amplifier.
And creates very crisp, very crisp sound.
Yeah.
And for bass, we are using either the PV Nitro bass,
right,
and or we're using the Fender Rumble.
Nice.
So that is our main small amplifiers. Yeah.
Okay, now what is the third most important part of your life?
Третья вещь, которая важна в моей жизни, на третьем месте. Да, я очень люблю на машине ездить. Я люблю управлять машиной.
The car. In general,
даже не так. Мне нравится американская автомобильная культура. Как все в Америке сделано под человека, едущего за рулем.
On the third place would be not just the car, not just driving, but American driving culture, where a lot of things are built around the experience that person can get by just traveling from one point to another. Like everything is drive-in. You can come anywhere, or you can get the, you know, a very civilized spots side of the road where you can fuel and get all sorts of things on your road. So the whole culture around personal cars and personal transportation is one of the big things in life.
Wow. You know, it's funny that he says that, because I don't know, man, I kind of honestly take it for granted. I don't even think about it. It's not even a thing for me, you know, just like, yeah, just get in my car and go. And I don't maybe I'm not appreciating it as much as I have. I do know that last night I was sitting just listening to some music, and I thought about it. Like, I used to go to like about 3-4 shows a week, you know, to cover the scene and etc. And I'm so glad that I did that, you know, like sleepless nights doing an interview at 2 in the morning or what have you, because I don't have it right now. And I miss the hell out of it. I miss my friends. I miss the loud amps in the face. I miss all of it. And maybe there is that part where, yeah, I might have taken a little of that for granted. Oh, and I've learned over the years not to take that part for granted, but the driving I never even thought of. But thank you for that. Okay, so what is number 4?
Высказывание. Нет, рисование именно. Я очень люблю рисовать. Да. То есть, ну, для меня как естественно, поэтому я даже забыл говорить. Yeah.
So one of the things specifically for Mike is his ability to create and draw specifically.
Mm-hmm.
So he, even though it's on the surface, but for him, he almost forgot it because it's so essential for him to be able to express his visual vision in the artistic form, in drawing specifically.
Right. Now, as I'm looking at you both, especially Mike, I see a lot of tattoo work. Did he create any of those, or not? I mean, not, he didn't tattoo himself, obviously, but did he create the art for it?
Yes, I do.
He forced his son to make those tattoos. Actually, on another thought, there is one tattoo which he did on himself. So this, I'm not sure if you see it.
Let me see.
But this Inyan that he has on forearm right there, and this one, he actually did it by himself. He used modified hair trimmer because, you know, in Russia there was no tattoo guns at large,
mid-90s, it was
like in mid-90s, that you cannot.
A lot of money. It's like electric guitar or something.
Yeah, it was
the same price.
So he had modified the hair trimming machine to actually become a tattoo machine to make those tattoos.
So wow. Now what?
Yes, for both.
What was it about? Like, did it, when you were in Russia, did they just not accept tattoo culture, or?
Нет, там очень большая татуировочная культура. Она идет еще с советских времен. Она вся была уголовная раньше и дореволюционная. Она была вся тюремная. Потом она стала выравниваться. Сейчас очень много людей делают татуировки. Все делают кучу машин, китайские машинки, все залито тушью. Все себе делают протоки, потом их сводят, в общем, весь.
Yeah, in Russia in general, even before the revolution, the tattoo culture was associated with, you know, criminals, jailhouses and stuff like
sailors.
That. Sailors.
As in,
you know, any other country. But, like, throughout the Soviet times, it was very marginalized. And even up to date, there are groups of people who want you to answer for the symbols that you're putting on yourself. So if you, God forbid, made a tattoo that looks like a jailhouse tattoo.
For example, you cannot tattoo a rat or
a cock.
A cock? Yeah, I mean
a rooster.
A rooster.
Yeah, I was gonna say that this different thing in America, my brother. You know, if I would assume that you wouldn't want a big cock on you. Maybe a smaller cock would be better for you.
It's just translation problem. Not a cock, a rooster.
Yes, I understand.
Name is this
little
bird? Yeah, rooster. Because rooster is a bad sign. Red is a bad sign. Goat is a bad sign.
Goat.
Goat,
yeah.
Is a bad sign. If you put it on your skin, it will be very big problem.
Yeah, and basically the people who've been in the jailhouse, they will.
Это маркеры крыса. Это тот, кто ворует у этих самых, а остальные это просто люди, находящиеся в самом низу.
Yeah, and basically those symbols, they are representing a certain society layers within the jailhouse culture. And
right.
If you have them, you're basically like a low life in the prison, so they will act against you as you are being low life.
I guess it's similar to some tattoo culture in the States, where if you have certain illustrations on you or certain tattoos, it's indicative of maybe, I don't know, you killed somebody or whatever it is. You're in a gang or whatever. Everybody has their certain symbols. I get it.
Like system of some markers or something like this for the person, and another person like. Тайное общество, secret society.
Yes.
You can see, the guy have, this good guy or bad guy, you know.
Yeah.
Wow.
This is like documents.
Jeez. And it's you know, and unless you get it lasered off, it's permanent. So, you know, that's something you got to deal with.
Yeah, and nowadays, nobody really cares. There's shitload of Chinese. Tattoo machines. Everybody's doing it. Everybody is making the messes. Everybody's removing them and doing another one. So it's right now it's a wild west in Russia with the tattoos, because a lot of like all the young people and all the people in general are just getting tattoos everywhere all the time.
Wow.
On the face.
So imagine it being like U.S. 90s, where everybody had piercings, everybody had tattoos. So this is how it is right now there.
And you've mentioned in a previous podcast where, you know, sometimes like the music has to catch up over there, whether it's a certain style or how
exactly.
Or how a guitar sounds. So maybe over there, there might be into some tribal tattoos, some barbed wire around the arm or something like that right now.
Exactly. Yep. Yeah.
It happens. Hey, at least it's a start. There's a start to the culture, and that's really important. So what is the final part of life for the top five?
Я бросил пить сейчас, потому что мне это нехорошо. от этого.
12 лет назад.
Да, 12 лет назад. А сейчас вот я могу курить марихуану. И мне это очень важно, потому что она мне... Это намного лучше, чем пить. Я думаю, для себя. Я решил для себя так.
Майк stopped drinking 12 years ago because, you know, it's not good for your health, not good for your mental state and your life in general.
Right.
And right now he's really thankful, and this is number 5 of his, you know, top 5 of everything is actually marijuana, because it helps him to, you know, think about certain things in a different way and overcome others by just taking puff and becoming young again, have a lot of thoughts and become creative.
Very too. Good for brain, because brain start to work in some young mood, you know?
It does work in a different way. I don't know if you've ever smoked and then all of a sudden, like I see this a lot, especially when I'm walking my dog. I'll take a few hits or whatever. I'll go out and walk the dog. And I start to hear stuff that not you know, like, oh, there's somebody, voices in my head, but you just hear different things and see things that just a little bit differently. That's like, it's just another way to view life and to probably be more creative.
Yeah, because if you, for example, if you drink too much and every day, you know, world inside you will be very poor, you know. It start to be poor if you drink too much every day, you know. And your main главная фигня в поведении, это как называется, эмоции. Your main emotion will be aggressive or something like this, you know.
Yeah.
How are you? You okay? Like this, you know.
It's very sloppy.
Yes, but if you smoking, you okay? You know, you can speak with people, you can socialize, you can do something, you can, you know, you do not sleep on the street.
And I got to tell you that it's changed so much. Now you can have so many different strains depending on what you're going to do throughout the day. If you want to be productive, if you just want to hang out on the couch and binge watch a television or something, you know.
Ну, может, иногда это тоже нужно.
Yeah, да. Sometimes you need it to just relax.
Just to chill out. Well, wind down after a hard day. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
Да, это очень помогает, когда человек устает тяжело, работает, и у него какие-то...
Yeah, it's a nice refresher
страхи, дурные мысли,
after
там,
a very long, stressful day when you have, you know, when you're overthinking what you've been working on, what happens next, and you just like spin in a tangent of those thoughts, and just to break out of cycle, it's a very good tool.
Absolutely. And thank you to both of you for interpretation and to giving me, and it's, you know, this is actually nice because this is this top five was a little more personal than I expected, and I'm honored that you shared that with me. So thank you very much to you both, and we're looking forward to seeing some brand new material coming down the road from the band Green Hog. Thank you so much, guys. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much to the guys in Green Hog for joining us, and big thank you goes out to Ian for mixing and editing and producing and doing everything that he does for this podcast, all things sound. Hit him up on social media at No Masters Audio. DoomTunePodcast.com. You can hear new and archived episodes. Do you want to hear the Green Hog episode from last year? Go ahead. It's on there. Across all forms of social media, it's DoomTunePodcast. And, yeah, same thing. DoomTunePodcast@gmail.com. Do you want to do an interview? Do you have a review you need done? A submission? Hit us up. We'll get back to you. I promise. Also, CraniumRadio.com, 6 to 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, each and every Sunday, all the music that you want to hear, and then some. So thanks, everybody. I appreciate you hanging out towards the end. Until that next time, meantime and in between time, stay healthy, stay happy, and above all, stay heavy.